that kindness is a simple act that can leave its effect on society. In the future, I would love to work with different nonprofit organizations about kindness and be able to get my message across to the world.
Please help me welcome to the stage, Elena Yoder.
Small school, there were not very many.
matter who he hung out with, Mason was bullied daily. One day, a few kids tried to talk him into getting something out of the equipment shed with the point of trying to lock him in. Luckily, this was unsuccessful, but as the days went by, nothing was being done. The constant tormenting went on. Not only has the physical bullying continued, but along with it, verbal as well. Mason has been called many names, one in particular, Fat Guy. These kids pick on, bully, hit, and slap Mason. One day, Mason wrote down on a poster board, "Bless God, and that he has made me really smart, talented, perfect, and most important of all, really special." Kids at school stopped bullying me and calling me names like Fat Guy. Thank you. Nikki, his mom, wrote a Facebook post explaining what she had found. A friend of hers in California that happens to be a teacher's aide saw it and had her students create encouraging cards of support for Mason. This illustrates the impact. The outpour of kindness made Mason feel loved and special. And since receiving the letters, Mason has worked on standing up for himself and has learned that two wrongs do not make a right. One day at school, someone was selling lollipops. Most kids got a lollipop, but one of the boys didn't have enough money to get one. It was one of the boys who had been bullying Mason. Instead of gloating and being happy for his misfortune, Mason bought him a lollipop instead. He overlooked the hate given to him by that boy out of the kindness in his heart. Mason, you continue to amaze me as the sweet and selfless person you are. This is a random act of kindness that changed a life. This is what we need to put into our everyday lives. There are over 160,000 kids who skip school every single day to avoid being bullied. That's right, you heard me, 160,000. Hurtful words about the way they dress, music they like, what they say, how they act, and origins they come from is what stands in the way of kids and their confidence all over the world. No matter which form it comes in, verbally, physically, or on the internet, bullying is an important issue. In a national study, 70.6% of people admit to witnessing bullying occurring in their schools. When bystanders step in, the bullying stops 57% of the time. But what about the other 43% of the time where nobody does anything? How in the world do we fix this? Kindness. Take that small bit of kindness, hold open a door, give a smile to a random stranger, help someone out, provide a compliment, whatever it is. Take it and please put it into the lives of everyone around you. Being kind to those around us can go a very long way. One simple thing can drastically change our world for the better. Kindness is teachable, contagious, and increases energy, happiness, lifespan, and pleasure. Theodore Roosevelt once said, "Do what you can with what you have where you are." Each person contains the ability to do something kind every day, no matter how big or how small. Maybe it is taking extra time to play catch with your kids, helping a friend with a project they need to get done, or supporting your siblings to finish their homework. What would happen if everybody made the decision to add just a bit of kindness into the lives of everyone around them? Whether it be at home, at work, or even just the plain strangers on the street, it makes you wonder whether all the violence could be changed into goodness with just a simple act of kindness. That simple act can echo around the society we live in. So, what are you going to do? Thank you.
calls, and he has something he'd like to say to you.
So, Elena, that was an amazing talk. I just want to acknowledge you for just being a stand for kindness. You're such a powerhouse and a light to this world, and I've heard you mention kindness and Ben's Bells, and as a representative of Ben's Bells, we were touched, moved, and inspired. We heard you speak about kindness, so I came to tell you a little something, and just to clue you guys in on what Ben's Bells is, it's an organization that started in Tucson about 14 years ago, around when Elena was born, by a woman named Jeanette. And what happened was her son, Ben, died all of a sudden at the age of 2. And she was devastated. And she said something that really helped her was kindness. Just small things. Someone smiling, or opening a door, or letting her into traffic. And she clung on to these things as, wow, these mean so much. But on the outside, I look like a normal human being. On the inside, I'm dying. And how many other people are going through something? And so she really wanted to bring this to light. And so on the first anniversary of Ben's death, she got together with some friends and family, and they made these elaborate wind chimes. They're beautiful. They have a little tag. It says, you found Ben's bell. Take it home and let it be a reminder to spread kindness through this world. And they distributed 400 on the first anniversary of Ben's death. And the Tucson community lost their minds. They loved it. And so she was a professor at U of A, and then she started a studio, and then people were coming to make these bells. So by the time one is done, 10 people have worked on it. And it's a community art project. It's really beautiful. So in 14 years, we started with 400 bells. We've now distributed 70,000 bells. Wow. There's four studios. I mean, we've been in New York, San Francisco. We were at Virginia Tech after those shootings. We were in Newtown, Connecticut after that school shooting. We've been around the globe. And the cool thing is, you can't buy a bell. You can only discover a bell randomly. So it is a super high honor to find or get a bell. I've been given special permission by Jeanette herself to give you a miniature bell.
Please come join us back in about 15 minutes. Thank you.
Timekeepers.